गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू द वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल ऑफ क्लासिक साइंस। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट बोन्स, जॉइंट्स एंड मसल्स। वी हैव ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड आर न्यू टॉपिक, दैट इज़ द गेट ऑफ एनिमल्स। सो एज यू ऑल नो दैट वट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ गेट, गेट मीन्स अ पर्टिकुलर वे ऑफ वॉकिंग। There are different ways by which animal moves from one place to another. So, a particular way of walking is known as the gait of animals. For example, cow, buffalo, dogs, cats use their hind limbs and forelimbs for walking and running. Snakes, slithers, birds use their wings for flying. Insects walk, fly and crawl. Fish swims. Okay, so there are different way of walking or running of different animals. We have already discussed about the movement of earthworm. Now our next topic is movement of snail. Snail is a very slow moving animal. It moves very slowly. Snail carries shell or rounded structure on its back, which is known as the shell of snail. So you can see here also, this is known as the shell of the snail, and a snail always carry this shell on its back. It is the outer skeleton of the snail but is not made up of bones. So this shell is the outer skeleton of the snail, but this shell is not made of bones, and the shell is a single unit and does not help in moving from one place to another. It has to be dragged along. So this shell does not help in moving from one place to another. It has to be dragged along, and the snail has only one foot. This is the foot of the snail. And the foot of the snail is large, flat and disc shaped, made of strong muscles. So you can see here, this is the foot of snail, and this foot is large, flat and it is a disc shape which is made up of strong muscles. It is not made up of bones, it is made up of strong muscles, and snail moves with the help of this foot. So this foot helps in the movement, but this outer skeleton or the shell does not help in movement from one place to another. Okay, now we will see how the snail moves. So this is the foot of the snail. This part is known as the shell or the outer skeleton. Okay, so the snail has a single foot, and this foot helps in the movement, but this outer skeleton does not help in movement, or this shell does not help in movement from one place to another. So this is how the snail moves from one place to another, by using their foot or single foot. So this is the movement of snail. Now let's move forward. So the next is the movement of cockroaches. Cockroaches can walk, climb as well as fly in the air. The body is covered with a hard outer skeleton which is made of different units joined together and permits movement. So the cockroach can fly, it can climb, or it can walk also. And the body is covered with a hard outer skeleton. This is the hard outer skeleton, which is made up of different units joined together, and this outer skeleton permits movement. Okay, they have three pair of legs, as you can see here also. These are the three pair of legs. A cockroach has a three pair of legs, and these legs help in walking. There are two pair of wings attached to the breast. So the cockroach has the two pair of wings, and the cockroaches have distinct muscles. and two pair of wings. They can fly only short distances, and cockroach walk in a very interesting manner, moving three legs at a time. Okay, and when a cockroach walks, its three legs support the body while the other three move the body forward, and the movement is repeated. However, this time the three legs that previously supported the body now move the body forward, whereas the three legs that previously moved the body now supports the body. Okay, in this manner the cockroach is able to walk. So a cockroach skeleton is outside its body, which is also known as exoskeleton. This is known as exoskeleton, and they have the three pair of joined legs. These are the three pair of joined legs. Okay, and strong muscles to pull these legs, which help them to walk or run. Okay. So this is about the movement of cockroaches. Now let's move forward. So this is the movement of cockroaches. Okay, they have the three pair of legs, and these legs help in the movement, enable them to walk or run. They have tiny claws that help them climb walls. These are the tiny claws. Okay, they have two pair of wings. They can fly only short distances. So this is the movement of cockroach. Now the next is the movement of birds. Birds fly in the air and walk on the ground. As you all know that they can fly in the air and they can walk on the ground. Okay. And some birds like ducks and swans also swim in water. So some birds, which are also known as the aquatic birds, can swim in water. The birds can fly because their body are well suited for flying. Their bones are hollow and light. So these hollow and light bones help them in flying because their body are very light and the bones are hollow. So these hollow bones support them in flying. So because of the light weight, the birds can easily fly in the air. Hind limbs are used for walking and perching. So the birds use their hind limbs for walking and for perching. Fore limbs are modified into wings. The shoulder bones are strong. Okay, so the birds have the shoulder bones or the strong shoulder bones. The breast bones are modified to hold muscles to flight, which are used to move the wings up and down. Birds fly by constant flapping of their wings. So now let's see the movement of birds, or let's see how the birds fly. So the bird flies by constant flapping of their wings. So these are the hind limbs, and the fore limbs are modified as wings. Okay, so these hind limbs and fore limbs help them in flying. And they use their hind limbs for walking and perching. So this is about the movement of birds. Now let's move forward. Now the next is the movement of snake. Snakes have a long backbone. They have many thin muscles, and they are connected to each other even though they are far from one another. So the snakes have a long backbone. They have many thin muscles, and these muscles are connected to each other. They also interconnect the backbone, ribs and the skin. So the backbone, skin and ribs of the snake are also interconnected. The snake's body curves into many loops. So the snake moves by forming different kinds of loops like this. each loop of the snake gives it a forward push by pressing against the ground. Since its long body makes many loops and each loop gives it this push, the snake moves forward very fast and not in a straight line. So the snake moves very fast, but the snake does not move in a straight line. So snakes never move in a straight line. They always move by forming these kinds of loops, and these loops help them in forward push. They gives it a forward push by pressing against the ground. So now we will see the movement of snake. So here you can see the movement of snake, and you can see that the snake never moves in a straight line. They always move by forming different types of loops, okay, and these loops give them a forward push. So the snake never moves in a straight line. Now next is the movement of fish. Next is the movement of fish. Body shape of fish is streamlined. The head and tail of the fish are smaller than the middle portion of the body. So you can see here also this forward and the backward part of the fish are smaller than the middle portion. Okay, and this shape is also known as the streamlined shape, in which the head and the tail of the fish are smaller than the middle portion. Okay, and the body tapers at both ends. This shape allows the fish to move in water easily. So the streamlined shape of the fish help them to move in water easily. The skeleton of the fish is covered with strong muscles. During swimming, the muscles make the front part of the body curve to one side and the tail part swings towards the opposite side. And the fish always forms a curve. Then quickly the body and the tail curve to the other side. This makes a jerk and pushes the body forward. What I am trying to say is, firstly, the first part of the body make a curve to one side like this. Okay. Then quickly the front part will curve to the other side and the tail part also curve to the other side like this. So this makes a jerk and pushes the body move forward, and a series of such jerks make the fish swim ahead. As you can see here also, firstly the front part curves to one side and the tail part curves to the other side, whereas and suddenly the front part curve to this direction and the tail part curves to this direction. So this make a jerk and help in pushing the fish forward. Okay, so this is the movement of fish. So this is how the fish moves. Now let's see the movement of fish. So this is the movement of fish. You can see here also the fish moves the front part in one direction and the tail part in other direction. This is how the fish moves. So this is known as the movement of fishes. And the fish has the front and the tail part is smaller than the middle portion. This middle portion is bigger than the tail and the front part. Okay, so we have done the movement of earthworm, movement of snail, movement of fish, movement of birds, movement of cockroach also. So with this we have reached to the end of this chapter. So thank you and see you in the next video.